Years of frustration for northern suburbs commuters may finally be over. The Gawler line is just days away from going fully electric. As exclusively revealed by Nine News last month, a 10th train has now been delivered, replacing the final diesel service.
A thumbs up that's taken the efforts of several successive governments and a whole lot of money and time. The Gawler line is finally about to go fully electric.
This is not how you do a project start to finish, but it's over now. At last.
Last month, Nine News exclusively revealed the delivery of the Gawler Line's 10th electric train, and today it was unveiled, ready to welcome passengers from Monday, which will also mark the end of the old diesel trains servicing Adelaide's north.
The Gawler Line is now fully electric, with this train completing our train set.
Trains are better, they feel smoother.
It's a project that's been a long time coming. After on-off talk since 2008, early works finally started in 2018, with funding secured to electrify the line all the way to Gawler. It was slated for completion in late 2020, but it wasn't until mid-2022 when the infrastructure was finally complete. Then there wasn't enough electric trains, so up until now, it's been operating a mixture of diesel and electric services.
It's been very frustrating as a uni student.
It's good that it's here though.
Long time coming.
Yeah, for sure.
And taxpayers have also had to burden huge cost blowouts to get the project finished. Passengers may occasionally see a diesel service operate on the line if one of these electric trains needs to go in for maintenance, but that will all change when more trains are delivered later in the year. The government hoping it will encourage commuters to get back on the train.
The people of the north have put up with a lot in waiting for this service. It's been a long journey.
There's currently no plans to electrify any other lines. For now, it's just Gawler, Seaford and Flinders. Ollie Haig, Nine News.